Well, so very good afternoon all of you. In the previous class, we have already discussed about the working principle of electron beam machining process. Construction and different parts of EBM in the last class already was discussed. And in today's class, I said that we will be continuing with the diffusion pump, which is a very important part. And it has got a significant role in machining process during this EVM process. Okay. Now, you might have already understood that there is a need to create or to keep a vacuum chamber inside the machining zone or in the machining zone. Right. Now, I have said in order to maintain the vacuum, you need to take help of diffusion pump. You need to take the help of a diffusion pump. Now, what is the diffusion pump or what will be the construction of it? As well as we need to know the working principle of it. You may be knowing that diffusion is the movement of a substance from an area of high concentration to an area of low concentration. And it can happen in liquids as well as gases. Okay. And many places you can check it out, like diffusion and all these things are taking place. Okay. So if you walk into a coffee shop and immediately smell some coffee, okay, my question is why? Now, one reason is convection, which you might have already studied in heat transfer. That means moving currents of air carry coffee smell particles all around the coffee shop. But even without convection, the smell would still reach your nose eventually, not by convection, but the process which is involved in this case is known as diffusion. In diffusion, coffee particles move from the coffee machine to the rest of the coffee shop. Okay, so where coffee machine is the area of high concentration and the rest of the coffee shop is an area of low concentration, right? And making a cup of coffee also involves the diffusion of coffee particles through hot water, right? So this is one example I just wanted to give you. Okay. Now, what causes diffusion? So I just want to give you basic idea, then we'll move ahead so you'll understand. Already in class 6, 7, or 8, you might have studied about diffusion. So in gases and liquids, particles move randomly from place to place. And the particles collide with each other or through their container once it is moving from one place to another place. This makes them change their direction. Eventually, the particles are sprayed through the whole container. That is what happens, right? So diffusion can happen in their own. You need not do anything else. Okay. So many other processes you might have already studied where diffusion takes place. Okay. Now, here also, in order to maintain the vacuum, we are going to take the help of a diffusion pump. First and foremost, let us have a look on the construction of a diffusion pump. So everyone, start drawing with me. Well, so this is the basic structure, Right, now I'll be showing how it works. Okay, so few more things we have to draw. One and here two. Okay. Now here we will have small nozzle kind of thing. Then we may have a channel, another one channel. So here also we'll have another one nozzle kind of thing. These are some sets of nozzle. We may have some more in number. So everyone, draw it, okay? Now outside of it, we will have something like this. And what are these, I'll tell you. Right. So meanwhile you draw, I'll be explaining and along with that I'll just point out what are the different parts in this diffusion pump, right? So first and foremost thing is, here we are going to have heating coil. Okay, what we are going to have here? Heating coil. We are going to have heating coil, right? And here we are going to have some liquid. Here we are going to have some liquid. Which liquid? This is some oil. Okay, right? I hope now you understood that the heater or this heating coil we have kept in order to heat the oil. Now, once the oil is heated, then what will happen? It will get evaporated or it will start moving up. It will get evaporated. And as it moves up, what happens? Here you can see this channel. From this channel, it will start moving to the top portion. Okay, it will start moving towards the top portion. So further heated and it will be moving in this direction. Right. Now, as it moves up, what happens? These are some set of nozzles. Okay, what are these? These things are set of nozzle. Set of nozzles, right? Okay. Now, what it does, it moves in this direction and then here we will have some exit of the nozzle. So, as it is getting converged, so gradually the pressure will start increasing. And from this nozzle, it will enter from this path and it will come out from another one path. Okay. So it will start moving in this direction. Okay. So from here, it will go. From here, it will go. Here also, it will start moving in this direction. Here also, it will start moving in this direction. Here also, it will start moving in this direction. Similarly, in this direction also, it will come out. Okay. So draw it neatly, right? So what happens? This will start coming out, right? Okay, I hope you people understood like what is happening, right? Now this side is connected with the EBM gun. The top portion is connected with the EBM gun. Okay, and what happens, this side, all the steam or this vaporized oil, it will start moving in this channel. Okay, this channel name is backing line. Backing line. Okay, so I think you people are understanding. So it will start moving in this direction. Okay, and here we are having something connected that is called rotary pump. Okay, so we are connecting it with a rotary pump. We are connecting it with a rotary pump. Okay. So if there is any residual air molecules because of the momentum of this gas, okay, of this oil jet, then air molecules which are present, that will be entrained in the jet from this place. Okay, so I'll draw with some other color. So what happens, this is connected with the EBM gun. That means in the EVM, in order to create some vacuum, here the pressure will drag. So what will happen? We will find some pressure difference. Here high pressure, this side as it is moving in this direction, it will cause a low pressure, which will allow the air which is present in the EVM gun to entrain in this path. And it will be dragged in this way, right? It will be pulled away in this way, okay? Right, so then everything would be removed through this backing line, or whatever air is present or molecules are present, that will come through this backing line and be via this rotary pump. Okay, with the help of this rotary pump, and in this way, within the electron beam chamber, which was somewhere here, okay. You might have already seen the electron beam chamber, which I have shown in the last class. Okay, so we create some vacuum. Okay, so this is something about the vacuum pump. Now you must be understanding like what are these. These are something which are known as cooling coil. Complete chamber will be heated due to this heating and all this process. So we must maintain some temperature of it, and that is the reason why we are connecting some heating coil which will be winded on this, right? And through that we are going to pass water. So that it will be maintained, or some temperature will be maintained in that. Okay, right. So how much generally vacuum we create, already in the last class I have discussed that it will be somewhere around 10 to the power minus 4 to 10 to the power minus 6 tons. Okay, right. So you might have understood what is the function of cooling coil. Okay, so it will also so that complete structure will work in a nice manner. Okay, clear. And so I hope you people understood about this, right? Okay, now next is that what is the mechanism of material removal. Okay, what is the mechanism of material removal? Okay, So in the last class, already you might have understood like what actually we need to do in order to remove material in this case. Okay. Now I will be explaining you one by one, process by process. I will be explaining you like how it works. Okay. So if you try to understand like how the electron beam gun looks, then you will be understanding that there are a series of operations which are going on and which are causing the material removal. Okay, right? So now let's have a look on it. So number one, we have energized the tungsten coil. Okay, so you have understood that we are causing some potential difference between the anode and the cathode. Cathode means the tungsten coil. And if we remember that through the slotted disc, okay, the electron beams are coming and they are impinging on the workpiece. Okay, so if we have like a, I would like to show you just a schematic diagram of it. You might have seen that electron beam gun was something like that. Here we had the magnetic or electromagnet. Okay, here we had the copper tungsten, tungsten filament, and through it we are keeping some anode over here. Okay, and it is coming in this direction. It will get deflected. So we are going to reduce the deflection and somehow we are going to concentrate it. I said that from here many electrons will come, few will be divergent in nature, few will be convergent in nature. We need to maintain some electromagnetic force over here so that the divergent electrons will be absorbed by this magnetic coil and the convergent one will pass out from the slotted disc, right? And then it will hit the workpiece and workpiece will be machined, right? So these things we have understood, okay? Right, and in the bottom, we have got some auxiliary material, which I have not discussed in the last class, but I will be discussing about it today. So here we have got the workpiece and here we have got, this is workpiece and this is auxiliary material. Okay, right. So first emission will take place from here. So this is connected with the negative terminal and here it will be connected to the positive terminal, which you may be knowing. Okay, so first we need to have some thermoionic electrons. First, we will have some thermoionic electrons. So these thermoionic electrons are getting emitted from this tungsten filament. Okay, these thermoionic electrons are repelled by the cathode and attracted. So this is cathode, this is anode. Okay, so this is repelled by the cathode. It is connected with the positive terminal, the negative terminal, which is known as cathode. You might know it. Okay, and the positive terminal is anode. Okay, so electrons will be attracted towards this positive terminal, that means anode. Okay, which I think you people know very well. All right, so this thermoionic electrons are repelled by the cathode and attracted by the anode through the bias grid. Here we have got the bias grid, already I have discussed in the last class. So they are accelerated and they almost means it will be half of the velocity of light, which I have already discussed in the last class. So you get a high velocity jet of electrons. Okay, so these electrons are shaped and focused by a series of magnetic and electromagnetic lenses. Here only one I have shown, but we may have a series of electromagnetic or magnetic lenses. And finally, this electron beam impinges with high velocity, okay, and high energy on the workpiece. Okay, so the second point, what is happening? Acceleration of electrons due to anode potential. Okay, so which is somewhere, you know, half C. Okay, right. Then after that, what is happening? Number three. So I'm just keeping it aside. We are continuing here. So number three. Number three is what? Acceleration. After acceleration, this high velocity beam of electrons will be produced. Will be produced. Okay, right? High velocity beam will be produced. Then fourth one is what? Shaping and focusing of the electron beams. Electron beam. Right, then fifth one is impingement of high velocity electron beam on the work. Okay, right, so this is what happens here, right? So after that, next our intention is what? It will create, I have already shown you what is the energy versus spot size. Okay, already in the last previous class I have drawn one graph, and I have shown you like what is the spot size. So we receive a spot size of somewhere around 10 to 100 microns. Okay, right. The spot size will be around 10 to 100 microns. So the density could be very high. Okay, so high energy density. High energy density. Okay, right. So energy density, it can be like somewhere around 10 to the power 4. It will be somewhere around 10 to the power 4 watt per mm square. Okay, right. And after that, number 8, we will find melting and vaporization. Melting and vaporization. Okay, heating and melting. Here heating will come. Heating, melting and vaporization in the workpiece. Okay, right. So the high velocity impingement, because of that we will find some kinetic energy will be produced. And because of that some heat generation also will be taking place, and finally the workpiece material will get heated, melted and vaporized, which will lead to material removal. Okay, right. So if you find, like already I have shown you the diagram, that say this is the workpiece. Okay, if this is the workpiece, underneath of that we will find some auxiliary material. Okay. This is workpiece. This is workpiece. Okay, right. So we will have some auxiliary material. Okay. Now, generally, this process, or we consider this EBM or electronic machining process for hole or making holes. Okay, or drilling. Generally, we produce holes. Now, what kind of holes we generate and how we generate? Okay, so now in the next one, let's discuss in a better way. So I'll first draw some diagrams. You people also draw along with me. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 diagrams I'll be drawing. Okay, you people also just draw along with me. First one, say this is the workpiece. Here we have got the auxiliary material. Okay, so if we are making some jet, say this is electron jet, here small crater will be formed. Okay, now step 2, what will happen? It will generate a little bit this kind of hole. Okay. Okay. So this is the electron beam. So here this kind of shape will be generated. Now in the third one, what will happen? The material will get removed like this completely. Okay, and in the fourth diagram you will find something like a bulb or keyhole generation. This is called keyhole generation. All right. Okay, so this is what we are going to get over here. So this is, say, the electron beam. Here we are having, this is the electron beam, right? Okay, so in a better way, now we can see. So once the electrons are impinging, what happens? Because of the kinetic energy being transferred into the thermal energy, we have localized heating. Localized heating by focusing electron beams. Electron beam. Right? So first this one only happens, right? Now next. So my localized heat, due to this localized heating, what happens? There will be a gradual formation of hole, which is shown here. Gradual formation of hole. Okay. Gradual formation of hole, right? Right. So why it happens? Because of the penetration and melts and vaporization. Okay. Right. Now this melt vaporization front develops here, okay, and it gets starts to penetrate. In this case, it will penetrate, and finally it will penetrate this auxiliary material. Okay, so this is the auxiliary material, and you can see this is your workpiece material. Okay, so severe melting and vaporization is taking place. Okay, and auxiliary material melts very fast and it produces vapor. So if there is any molten metal in the path, what happens? It will eject that molten metal, forming a proper hole leading to electron beam machining or electron beam drilling. Okay, so finally it will cause this, so this portion will melt and it will get vaporized. So finally we will be able to drill this path. So because of the presence of auxiliary material, there will be a tremendous high vapor pressure which will remove any molten bare metal. You understood now why we are keeping this auxiliary material? Once again, I am saying this auxiliary material, okay, this is kept because it will melt and vaporize very fast, and because of the tremendous high vapor pressure, because of melting and vaporization of the of this auxiliary material, it will flush away, okay, the melt part of this workpiece, right? And it will form the hole properly. I hope it is clear to you, right? Right. So third, after that, say what happens? Penetration till auxiliary support. Okay, penetration till auxiliary support. Then next is you will find like explosion of any molten material or any molten material at the top by high vapor pressure. Of auxiliary material. Okay, this auxiliary material, it melts and vaporizes very fast. Okay. I hope now you understood the importance of auxiliary material also. Okay. So now let us deal with another one thing, which is the process parameter of this EBM. Just a minute. Process parameters, which is very important one. Okay, so first process parameter is accelerating voltage. Accelerating voltage. All right. So where is that accelerating voltage? You might have seen that the cathode and anode has been given some voltage. Okay, that cathode is connected with the negative terminal of the power supply or power source, and anode, that means the bottom side, is connected with the positive terminal of the power supply. You might have already seen. Okay, so between the anode and cathode we have accelerating voltage. So how much it can be? It could be hundreds of kilovolts. Okay, hundreds of kilovolts. Okay, then second one we have got is beam current. Beam current will range, okay, So what is beam current? This is the current flowing between the cathode and the workpiece. Okay. And the beam current will be somewhere around 250 microampere to 1 ampere. Right. Now, third one is pulse duration. Pulse duration. Okay. So you have already seen about the biased bridge or pulse bridge. Okay. So that is very important because only during that phase, we are allowing the electron beam to impinge on the workpiece. So typically the range of it will be somewhere between 50 microseconds to 50 milliseconds. Okay. Right. Now, if someone is multiplying these two terms, okay, so you will be getting an energy per pulse. Okay. Energy per pulse. Okay. So this will be also in the range of somewhere around 100 joule per pulse. Okay. 100 joule per pulse. Right. So power per pulse is also important as energy pulse is important. Okay. So we need to have power per pulse. Power per pulse. Okay. Right. Then after that, we have to go for the lens current. Lens current. Okay. So the lens current will determine to what extent the electron beam is focused. You might have seen that electron beam will be focused from the lens. Okay. So it will determine, or the current which is present, it will determine the convergence, or how much it will be converged, right? Or how much it will be focused, right? Then this is about the lens current. Okay. So we need to pass large amount of lens current in the electromagnetic lens. Okay. And that will also determine my spot size, and spot size will be somewhere typically spot size. Okay. So it will be somewhere in between 10 microns to 500 microns. Okay. Right. And even it can be for 500 microns also, right? So it can be that big also, right? So 100 microns, 10, 200, anything can be, right? Now next, eighth one is power density. Power density. So what is the power density? So if the power density can be derived from the equation, I will just tell you, this is the last point of today's discussion. Half mv, that means electrons mass and v square divided by pi by 4 into da square. So where pd is nothing but the power density, pd is nothing but the power density, you know, mass and velocity. And what is d? This is the spot diameter. Okay. And why we have multiplied by pi by 4? Because we want to get the area of spot size, spot area. It can also be written in this form like VAIBTON divided by pi by 4 into dS square, where this V is nothing but the accelerating voltage, IB is nothing but the beam current, and TON is the nothing but the pulse on time or the beam pulse duration. Okay. So this is how we can determine this PD, that means power density. Okay. Now, so these are some process parameters which are involved in EVM process. Okay. Now, I hope you people got some idea. Okay. Now, next class, I'll be discussing about the hole characteristics and also like how the beam is focused, or what are the different ways of focusing the beam. So those things I'll be discussing in the next class. Okay. So I hope you people have noted down all these points. Okay. Which are important points. Okay. Right. So we'll meet you in the next class. I hope you people understood today's topic.